Okay, I'm going to do this simultaneously, but not uploading simultaneously, just taping. We put out a call to do a dollar store challenge collab. It was supposed to be up to $50 for business or crafting. So I went today and I got some of my things, and I will show you what I got. And so this is going to be for my embroidery. So I'm going to show you my first bag. I got this container for bobbins, for the embroidery machine bobbins, so that I can put them in here, and I'll put that up there. Then I am going to upload this on my YouTube channel, because I got this idea from the baby's booty, and they went and got these eyeglass cases, and because they are good, because they open all the way, see, and you can put them on the embroidery machine, so these can be personalized, and they're cute because they have this tag. Hi Gigi, how are you doing? They have this tag to hang from your bag. So I got one. I figured I could do a nice navy blue thread on this one. This one, it's blue and green and black. I can do a nice either blue or black outline. And then I got a red one because I love red. Then I got a pink one because I love pink. And then I got this teal one because this is my daughter's favorite color. So I will probably embroider her name or her initial on here. So that's $1, $2, $3, $4, $5, $6 so far that I got at the dollar store. Okay. Now, my second bag. Okay. This one is my favorite bag because I got these blanks to embroider. Okay, let me put them together so that you can visualize, see my vision. Okay, hold on. Well, they didn't have red towels, so I didn't get red towels. So because I am brand new at embroidery, I decided that I was going to buy some blanks at the dollar store and practice. So I got these microfiber towels. You see them? Microfiber towels. There's two in a package. They're little cleaner uppers. So I got two green, two blue. Then I found, if I wanted to get bolder, once I did these and I saw that I could do these, I'm going to graduate to these. There's a black one and a red one. So that was $6, $7, $8, $9, $9 so far. $9. So, but then I saw these mitts. So I decided that I can either heat transfer an initial or embroider it, because the other lady that I watched in embroidery, Candia, I forgot what her last name was. She opens these and then she puts them on her hoop and then she embroiders them and then she sews them back up. So here's a set, and you have the glove, you have the towel that I can embroider, and you have the pot holders. So that was $6, $7, $8, $9, $10, $11, $12 so far. $12 so far. Then I have a blue set also. So that's $12, $13, $14, $15. Okay, and then in one of the embroidery videos that I saw, the one lady uses these shelf liners to place on her table when she hoops her material so that her hoops don't slide. So I said, well, you know, it's a dollar, I may as well get it. And what she did was she cut off a piece and then she used her hoop for a pattern and she cut the inside of the shelf liner so that when she pinned her stabilizer and her fabric, it wouldn't catch to the shelf liner. So I got shelf liner. So that's another dollar. If anybody's keeping track, I forgot already. I actually got 4 bags. So let me see. Is that my 4 bags? Oh, no, there's another bag that's missing. Hold on. This is my favorite bag of all. I got 15 of these cute little babies to embroider. Okay. So I have bears, I have bunnies, I have yellow, green, pink. And these are from the dollar store. And the two ladies that I watch embroider, they open these little teddy bears and then they embroider. But I found, and here's a little lamb. He's a little lamb. Okay. I can't. What I saw was this, okay? They have a felt heart and they sewed it to the little hands. So if I am not ambitious enough to open the little teddy bear to embroider on the chest, I can always go find some red felt, embroider the red felt, I gotta cut that, and attach it to their little hands. So, you see, I went and I measured all of them to see if their hands closed. See if the hands closed. So all of these, so that's 15 right there. So basically, that is my haul, except that I got some, I got 6, where are they? 6 vacuum seal bags. Okay, I don't know where I put them. 6 vacuum seal bags. Yep, I don't know where I put them. So that I can, whoops. He committed harikari. So I can put these in a sealed vacuum bag and get the air out, and I can store them because I have bags and bags of these little teddy bears from the dollar store, because I used to personalize them with the heat transfer, but people sell these for $10 and I just don't have the heart to sell them for that price because they're from the dollar store, you know what I mean? And I really don't know like how safe they are. But, you know, they're a cute addition to add to like a gift basket. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to ask my daughter the names of all the little kids in my granddaughter's preschool. And I'm going to embroider. I'm going to go get more of these. And I have some in the bags. I have Christmas elves and I have some Christmas teddies and stuff. So I'm going to embroider all the kids that are in the preschool, their name, and I'm going to, to send them to the preschool with her. Hold on, maybe that other bag is on the bed, on this bed here. Did I bring that last bag in? That's weird. That is so weird. Okay, we may have left it in the car. I don't know, but I thought I had, oh, here they are. Sorry. Okay, so let's move the teddies out of the way. I found the vacuum bags. This was another thing that I learned from the baby's booty. And what she does is she gets these vacuum seal bags. Okay, this is the large. I couldn't find the extra large. And she stores all her teddy bears and fabric that she's not using right away. So I said that's a great idea, because you can put, like right now it's really cold here. It's like, you know, 39, 43 degrees. So we pulled out the heavy duty blankets. But in another week or so, you know, what do we do after we, you know, we took them out? And well, I figured, okay, well, I'll use half of these for the teddy bears and the blankets that I have to embroider. And then the other, like the other two, or the other half, or the other three, I'll, when I, you know, take the blankets off the beds, I will wash them and dry them with the fabric softener sheets to make them smell nice. And then I will put them in the Ziploc bags so that I can store them better and, you know, not take up so much space. So this was my haul, and it was a challenge to spend up to $50 for business or crafting. So I'm going to show my receipt. Okay, all the information is gone from the receipt. So there is what I spent, and I bought three bags of candy. So we spent $33. Can you see that? $33. $33 with tax. And these last things were candies that we bought. And my candy, which is the sweethearts, is business related, because, you know, I'll eat the sugar while I'm working to give me energy. So here's the receipt. Sunglass case, oven mitts, holders, the monkey, the funny bunnies, the bags were $1. And there is one bag in each. So I guess I can go back and spend the other 20, but I think that I have enough things to work on. See the receipt, and those bags were $1. I have enough items to work with for now. And since it will be the first time that I will be embroidering anything with the machine, I think that I erred on the side of caution. Now, there was another thing that I wanted to get, which was the foam to do the puffy embroidery on the hats. But I guess I can pick that up another time. But so far, this is what I have to work with. And this is what I will work with. And the next part of the first part of the challenge, I couldn't film because they wouldn't allow me to film at my dollar store. So it was, you know, to go around and looking at things and, you know, saying, you know, like what I would use them for. So I wasn't able to do the first part of the challenge at my dollar store. But this is the second part of the challenge, is show you what I bought and what am I using it for. And the third part of the challenge will be the finished products. So wish me luck, and hope to see you. And if anyone wants to take part of this challenge, we're not going to be like uploading final cuts till the day after Valentine's Day. So that's February 15th. So let me know. Either leave me a comment, a message, DM me, YouTube Messenger, however you can find me. Just, you know, send me a message and let's do this. Let's try to do this. And it's a challenge, a dollar store challenge, up to 50. So it could be, you know, $5, $10, $20, $25, $30, $45, whatever. No more than 50. it's for business or crafting. Like if you're going to resell it or you're going to use it in your crafting projects. Let's do this. Maybe next time we could do like an IKEA $50. That's the one I really wanna promote. This one first, and then maybe another one with IKEA up to $50. So bye. Thank you for watching, and thank you for spending this time with me.